Hi guys, Deb Acker here, back with another video. And the title of today's video is There Are No Quick Fixes. So first and foremost, if you are new to this channel, welcome. I'm an intuitive coach and I work mainly with women to help them to heal their past and heal their childhood patterns, specifically around abandonment and the abandonment that can show up when we have physically and or emotionally unavailable parents. And if you grew up in that environment, whether it's because of a parent passing away, divorce, addiction, even just a parent working a lot, you were likely looking for a quick fix, quote unquote, to stop the pain that had happened living in that environment, likely subconsciously, right? So first and foremost, notice if on some level, when you were a kid, you developed some kind of like, basically, you know, tell me the answers, or, you know, I just want this to be over, if you developed any of those patterns. So now we go into our adult world, right? And we're just wired this way anyways, right? We're looking for quick fixes to money, to love, to health. I mean, we're just looking for the magic pill, right? And while there might be magic pills somewhere, or someone needs to create one of them, right? In the meantime, I just wanna share with you some awarenesses to really help you understand why there are no quick fixes, right? And how can you create things quicker in your life, right? So first and foremost, Bruce Lipton, he talks about this concept that 95% of the world is energy, right? And only 5% is the physical. But most of us are focused on creating in the physical world, right? So, you know, we want a job and we go online and we apply for jobs, right? And obviously that's an important step. You can't just like close your eyes and visualize it and then hope that you magically have a job without applying for any or taking any steps in the physical world to create that. But it's so important that you're in the right energy, right? So, you know, if you're applying for that job, you wanna make sure you're in the right state of being, right? That you're feeling the type of job that you want, you're feeling how you wanna feel in that job, you're feeling what it's like to, you know, connect and talk with your coworkers, right? You're feeling what it's like to do the job, right? So all of those are gonna be important pieces in addition to the physical world action of networking or, you know, like I said, going online and applying for jobs and or going to a career coach, right? And figuring out what it is that you wanna do. So that's one piece of this. Another piece of this is that, say for instance, you know, you are an entrepreneur, right? And you're like, I wanna hit six figures this month, say for instance, right? You might hit six figures, right? Without doing anything besides doing, you know, you're like, okay, I'm gonna put this program out in the world and I'm gonna hit six figures. Inside, if you are incongruent with those six figures though, at some point, the blocks that you have to being able to sustain that, to being able to create that regularly in your world, those blocks are gonna come up no matter what, right? So understand, sure, you know, you might have this quick result in some way, right? And I remember seeing this thing, it was a joke, like an ad on probably on Facebook or something, but, it was talking about, you know, I'm going to teach you how to make, $1 million in, in, 1 month or something like that. And what the guy did is he sold tickets to, I don't know the numbers right now off the top of my head, but he sold tickets to, you know, for $1,000 each. And then he basically, it was a joke, it was like class is over because he sold it to that number that would equate to 1 million people, right? Or to $1 million, right? He's like, look, I did it. So point being is that understand there are no quick fixes and it's really about working with your insides, working with your energy to really create that in your life and making sure that if you have blocks that you heal those. And in the comment section below, I will post a couple of videos that where I share how do we heal those things, right? But it's so important that you understand that and that you know that. And as part of this too, one other piece of this is that sure, you know, you don't necessarily have to heal your blocks. The other thing you could do is just literally in present moment, keep choosing to feel yourself being in that job. For instance, we go back to that example that I used, right? So you could feel yourself being in that job. You could feel what it would feel like. You could feel, you could feel what it's like to talk to your coworkers. You could feel all the excitement. You could feel even like the amount of money you're making in that job, right? You could do all of that and keep choosing it in present moment. And it's at least at a minimum, likely to create it a lot quicker. My sense of it is that even in doing so, if you have underlying blocks, at some point, those are gonna show up. And if you, obviously, if you keep pushing them to the side, as many of us have seen over time, right, you know, what's gonna happen is the message is gonna get louder and louder and louder. So that is today's video. If you are enjoying this series, make sure you subscribe to my channel. It is always my intention to give you new awarenesses, ideas, concepts, and really to help you to really, first and foremost, realize, you know, see the connections from your past to your present, and then start to live in the present, creating the life you really want. And of course, too, below, in addition to those videos, there's a ton of resources, including my complimentary Healing Through Abandonment kit. And so until next time, have a great rest of your day, and I will look forward to seeing you soon.